going on, everybody? This is your girl, Simply Betty 101, finally coming back with a new video. I know it's been a while. No, I'm not dead. Today's video is gonna be basically what I've been going through for the last, I think it's what, been what, 3, maybe close to 4 months since the last time I posted a video, which has been a very long time. But basically just distractions that I've been going through in life thus far. Now we are back. So if you want to know about life's distractions, stay tuned in for this video for today.
Focus.
You have to think about all the distractions that are making you spin your wheels. For me, it was mostly because I had so much going on, you know, traveling from East Coast to West Coast within a 2-week span and celebrating, you know, the holidays, Thanksgiving, and Christmas, which was wonderful. I hosted Christmas for the first time this year and it turned out so great. And I did not take any pictures, nor did I record in any videos, but the food was amazing. Yes, your girl cooked it all by herself and it was amazing. Not to, you know, give myself props, but if you guys do follow me, you do know I do cook on a regular basis and I do like to try new things. But through the holidays, I know holidays can be extremely hectic. Like, I don't know what some people be thinking when they are like, oh, you should be in the holiday spirit. Me as a mother, being in the holiday spirit is going to be a little tough for me because I have to get everything in order, and I'm talking about everything. House has to be prepared for guests. You gotta make sure you get all these gifts. You gotta make sure the gifts are wrapped. And then you have to cook and all of it. Like, I literally wanted to be the Grinch for Christmas. I kid you not. I was exhausted. But we got through the holidays. Everything was wonderful. Everything was great. Everyone enjoyed themselves, especially my son and my mother, who got awesome gifts this year. Moving forward until 2019, where we get through the new year, I didn't do anything. I didn't do no cooking. I literally just sat there, cuddled up. And now we're going into Mardi Gras season. Well, actually, Valentine's, then Mardi Gras. I think they're the same this year. But anyway, getting through these different distractions, sometimes with life, especially like if you're working, for instance, and you have toss-up feelings, basically. The week starts and you're like, yes, I'm going to focus, I'm going to get it done. And then by Wednesday, you're questioning your judgment, you're questioning life decisions. And by Friday, you just thank God it's Friday. And you're looking at all these different avenues, you're looking at all these people on social media who look like they're enjoying their lives and yada 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 yada, all these things, distractions. First off, you have to figure out if that particular job that you are at, is that a distraction to keep you from what you're supposed to be doing or a field that you're supposed to be in? That relationship that you are going through that is on a constant merry-go-round, you have to decide, is this a distraction or is this preparing me where I need to go to the next level? Is this the person I'm supposed to be with? There's a lot of distractions going on in everything that you do. This, me and my husband were just discussing the other night that our different personalities sometimes distract from our bigger goals that we want as far as a couple. I am an ambivert, and if you don't know what that is, person who is basically an introvert and an extrovert, 50-50. But my husband is a complete introvert, and sometimes that is hard for me when I am in that go-go-go mode and just, yeah, I just want to be a social butterfly, and I want him to also be a social butterfly, but that's not really his personality. So we kind of butt heads on things like that, and I know you're probably thinking, well, why would you butt heads on that? Well, it gets a little tricky, especially when it comes to family events, vacations, and things of that nature. It can be really, really hard, those two personalities to mesh together perfectly. Those are the types of distractions where you literally have to sit yourself down, you know, give yourself a pep talk, figure out exactly what you want or the things and your goals. Think about distractions. They can discourage you on a lot of things that you're trying to accomplish. you have to take into account that discouragement is another type of distraction. It can lead you away. You can go off of your path of where you're supposed to be, and it can be hard, especially if you don't have that support system in your corner, getting you back on the right path, you know, keeping you focused, pushing you. It's really, really hard to stay focused. Now, for others, it may just be completely easy for you. You may have that go-getter, just type mentality where it's complete focus all the time, 24/7, and no, please don't look at my nails. I will be going to the nail shop today. Just have precision focus. That's kind of hard for some people, especially me, because I get distracted all the time, literally. I kid you not, I have a to-do list in my head. I was like, okay, I need to record this video. I need to go to the mall and get these shoes for my bridesmaid dress. I need to go get my nails done. Also need to go get some stuff for working out, because then I need to finish laundry and I gotta cook, and it's literally a to-do list. And me being a homemaker or housewife or stay-at-home mom, don't get it twisted. It's just a lot. That is a big job. And, you know, and I got distracted by letting life basically consume what I was supposed to be doing. Kind of got discouraged as far as doing YouTube. You know, I've had this idea of distractions and discouragement video for about a month, maybe like mid-December, and I just never sat down and did it, because prior to that, after my last video, I kind of got discouraged. You know, I had a video partially edited, ready to post, and I never posted it because I wasn't sure if that's what I really wanted to post about. And then, you know, days go by, weeks go by, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, this needs my attention, that needs my attention. So it kind of just pulled me away. I even took my website down. For those who follow my website blog, I took my website down for maybe about a month, month and a half. Then I uploaded it again and posted one blog, and that was like December 7th or 12th or something like that. Again, even after that, life just distracted me from really giving YouTube a fair shot. My goal at the end of the year was to at least have 100 subscribers, and though I'm not that far from it, because I let all these other things pull me away, I felt like I really didn't give YouTube a fair shot. That is going to be part of my focus board this year. I will give YouTube a fair shot. I just want to make sure, you know, is this what I need to be doing or what I should be doing? Is this what I really want to do? My website, I'm also going to be revamping, reposting, and just really focusing on, well, I'm trying to focus. I literally am pulled in so many different directions, but you know, I am excited. I do have more, you know, videos and ideas coming up. Take away from this video, try to stay more focused. If you have to be doped up on coffee to stay focused or some type of caffeine, I would say not to overdo it so that you don't end up in the hospital. But I do understand that some people's focus is a little bit harder, especially if you have like ADD and, you know, all these other things that's going on in your life. People don't understand. Sometimes it is really hard for a person like myself to focus and just stay on the task and stay on the path. But, you know, you gotta try to implement a system that works for you. And notice I said a system that works for you, because all systems don't work for everyone. If they did, we would all be robots. You know, try to stay focused. Sit yourself down. Give yourself a pep talk. Try to decide exactly what is a distraction, what is something that is serious that you need to focus your energy and time on. I would say do a pro and con list. If it's something that you're into as far as relationship, job, do a pro and cons. If the pros outweigh the cons, try to stick with it. But if your cons outweigh those pros, toss it to the side. Anything that dealing with emotions, especially dealing with your emotions, because I don't think people realize your emotional health also plays a big factor in staying focused. If you're not happy, if you're not satisfied, if you're not thrilled to do this, if you're sad, if you're depressed, if it just brings too much negativity, it is a discouragement and it is also a distraction. So, promise this video would be short. This is just an update video and a little pep talk video starting for the year of 2019. Happy New Year to everyone. I look forward to showing you guys more videos, and I will see you guys later. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. You can also hit me in the comment section below, and I will see you guys later. Mwah. wonder what you should cook for dinner. Let me check something out.